Organic species that contain unpaired electrons are known as free radicals. As you can see here, we draw the unpaired electron as a single dot next to the atom on which it resides. In this lesson, we will explore the structure and reactivity of radicals, starting with the geometry of radicals, their frontier molecular orbitals, and then progressing on to how to draw radical reactions and radical chain mechanisms. We'll end with a discussion of radical intermediates involved in biological metabolism by cytochrome P450 enzymes. A quick look at the Lewis structure of a simple free radical provides insight into its expected reactivity. Notice that around the radical center there are only 7 electrons, 2 each from the 3 single bonds, and 1 from the unpaired electron. Thus, we would expect the radical to be an electron-deficient species, and this is what chemists observe. Radicals do not react with highly electrophilic species like carbocations. Instead, they prefer to react with other radicals, double bonds, and single bonds. Notably, they also don't react with lone pairs. The geometry of radicals can vary from planar to slightly pyramidal. However, pyramidal radicals rapidly invert through a process analogous to the inversion of an umbrella. Thus, a time-averaged picture of radical geometry treats the radical as planar and sp2 hybridized, and places the unpaired electron in a 2p atomic orbital. This description of radical geometry is important because it tells us that other molecules that react with radicals can do so from either the radical's top face, which in this picture is above the plane, or the bottom face, which in this picture is below the plane. To an incoming molecule, both faces look the same. Before discussing the important frontier molecular orbital in radicals, we need to learn a convention for describing the movement of a single electron. Most electron flow arrows represent the movement of electron pairs, since filled orbitals contain 2 electrons that move together during chemical reactions. However, radical reactions are an exception to this rule and always involve the movement of at least 1 unpaired electron. To represent this movement, we draw a half-headed or fishhook arrow from the radical electron to wherever it is going. In the 3 examples that follow, pay attention to how the number of electrons and type of bond in the reacting species influence the nature of the product or products. In the first example, a radical reacts with an even electron alkene, producing a radical. In the second example, 2 radicals combine with one another to produce an even electron species. And finally, in the last example, a radical reacts with the single bond of HBr, producing an even electron product and a separate bromine radical. Keep these 3 paradigms of radical reactivity in mind as we move forward. Believe it or not, nearly the entire spectrum of radical reactivity can be described using only these 3 elementary steps. In the next webcast, we'll look at the frontier molecular orbitals of radical intermediates.